Welcome to Bob Cage in Ontario.
The arena is like the hub of our great little town.
Our number one priority is to improve accessibility to the building. Automated doors that improve floor surfacing so that anybody can come in.
Kraft Hockeyville has established a 15-year-long legacy of breaking down barriers and encouraging participation in Canada's beloved sport all week long, and this has been fun. We've been profiling the nominees here on Breakfast Television. Today, we have with us City Councilor for Bob Cajun and Kawartha Lakes, Kathleen Seymour Fagan. Good morning, Kathleen. Congratulations on the nomination. This is exciting. Whose idea was this to throw Bob Cajun's name in the hat?
It was a local resident here, Mike Muddy. He decided to do it and put it up on social media, and then a team of one of our local volunteer groups, Impact 32, ran with it.
I can't think of Bob Cajun without mentally thinking of the Tragically Hip. How often do you say to people, I'm from Bob Cajun, and they go into lyrics of the song Bob Cajun?
All the time, yeah. It's what they know, that's what they know Bob Cajun as, is a Tragically Hip song. But we're much more than that.
Oh, obviously, yeah, a lot more than that. In fact, so a lot of NHLers that we've heard of have come out of Bob Cajun. Joe Junkin, Bernie Nichols, Matt Duchene, Brady Austin. This is a town that loves its hockey. What's the role of hockey in Bob Cajun? How big of a sport is it?
It's huge. It's hockey, but it's also community. When I moved here, we had young boys and started attending hockey games. They started playing. So the families become your family as well. So it's not just, you know, the game. The sport's amazing. It builds so much integrity and stuff for the kids, but it's also the entire community around it. It surrounds, you know, multi-generations.
We showed a few shots there at the community center. And again, to remind people at home, the winner of Kraft Hockeyville, you go to crafthockeyville.ca and vote starting April the 9th. Not only do you get $250,000 worth of improvements to the local arena and to the community, but you get to host an actual NHL preseason game with NHL teams coming in. But I want to focus, Kathleen, on the community center here. Obviously, hockey is the heart and soul of it, but I know recently it's been home to more than just hockey. Is that right?
Absolutely. We have the Ontario Step and Fiddle Dance competition that happens there. We have the Fall Fair that happens there. Many, many concerts. So it's somewhere that, you know, the community gathers. There's weddings being held there. Currently, it's not open. We haven't been open this whole season. So the kids have had to travel to other towns to play when they actually could play.
Kathleen, I mean, I'm sitting here in Toronto. I live a little outside of Toronto. I know how the pandemic has affected us. In a community like yours, what has this last year been like for you?
So this time last year, we were hit hard. We were the first small community that one of our nursing homes was hit. So at this time, we were doing a lot of press. A lot of attention was on Bob Cajun because we were the first ones to get hit hard. So this year, we'll have some great press. The town has come together again. It's fantastic, you know, to see this happen because it's been hard on everyone here, from the families to the kids. To the town, you know, we rely on everyone coming up and visiting our town. And, you know, when they heard what happened here, people didn't want to. But now everyone's up. And, you know, the support for our town is what we need.
Kathleen, all the best to you. We appreciate it. Good luck in the vote. Thank you for this.
Okay, thanks so much.
Again, repping Bob Cajun and the Kawartha Lakes. Could have been the Willie Nelson. Could have been the wine. It could be your vote. Go to crafthockeyville.ca. That gets Bob Cajun into the winner's circle for Kraft Hockeyville. Again, they can host an NHL preseason game plus $250,000 in arena upgrades. Voting opens April 9th. Winner will be announced April 10th. That's going to be fun to watch. And thanks to everyone who participated and said hello to us this week on Breakfast Television. Coming up a little later on, you sound off. It's April 1st. It's April Fool's Day. A lot of you love April Fool's Day because of all the pranks and stuff. The question today is simple. What's the best prank you ever pulled or was pulled on you? 1-866-267-3787. Feedback at breakfasttelevision.ca. Twitter at Breakfast TV. Good morning. You're watching Breakfast Television. More after this.